Now, in 2022, the Asian Development Bank conducted a study involving Grab drivers in Metro Manila, Cebu, and Davao. The goal was to see how the platform helped stimulate the economy and help mitigate unemployment. Joining us for more is ADB's Takashi Yamano. Takashi-san, good morning. Thank you for joining us. Hi.
Good morning, Michelle. Thank you for having me on your program.
All right. So what is your take on the pivotal role of Grab and Grab delivery for the Philippine economy? What are the key takeaways from your study?
Okay, so during the pandemic, we saw the expansion of Grab or other delivery business. We call them gig economy. Mm-hmm. Gig economy is based on the tasks that the workers engage on and paid for, not by hours. So the key takeaway from this is that the workers enjoy independent flexibility in working hours, and also decent earnings and independent working conditions. Many drivers we talked to said that they enjoy not having supervisors observing their work. So they are enjoying independent work. Decent earnings, on average, workers earn about 5,700 peso per week. This adds up to average monthly wage of 23,000 peso with Grab. We asked about their previous jobs, and their previous jobs, they earned about 15,000 pesos. So in general, they are enjoying flexible working conditions and decent earnings showing on the screen, and also the independent working conditions.
Mm-hmm. I wonder, Takashi-san, has the world reopening rendered the study and the results outdated then? I mean, e-commerce has plateaued, people are eating out again. How's the impact been?
I think overall, outside of the Philippines, inside of the Philippines, this gig economy is expanding. This local delivery is a localized gig economy. There is also other section, which is web-based gig economy, where the workers are taking jobs on the internet and deliver jobs on the internet. This web-based gig economy is expanding very fast, as well as the localized gig economy, like the food deliveries or other deliveries.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. All right. So you think that the strength of the gig economy with Grab delivery is just as strong today as it was at the peak of the pandemic, or has that also plateaued, at least?
Well, that was our question at the beginning of the survey we conducted last year. We asked our respondents, 12,000 of them in Manila, Cebu, and Davao, and we asked them, were they willing to continue their work with Grab food delivery? 90%, more than 90% of them said that they would continue after the pandemic. So it was not the one-time shift to this work, but that they are intending to stay with the work. And I believe that this workforce will continue to expand.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Takashi-san, has the study also considered the tax implications of Grab in the country? Because there's now a very big push to tax digital services. I have to admit, I'm quite unclear if Grab Philippines will fall under that, you know, taxing digital services, or whether Grab is actually currently paying already. We are waiting for details from the DOF as well. We have extended the question to them, but what has your study revealed?
So our study is based on interviews with drivers. Mm. And it is important for the driver to be part of social programs, like social insurance programs, social security programs, other social programs. So although they are independent contractors, bringing them into the social economy, formal economy, is very important. So helping them to be part of their social programs. But on the other hand, as the workers in the economy, they need to consider about their own tax payment and other form of engagement with the economy.
Hmm. All right. This clearly, really, for those who go over it, the paper is clearly supportive of this gig economy setup. But I also want to raise the proverbial challenge or criticism question that in this kind of model, gig workers hired as independent contractors should really be classified as employees. And when you don't do that, this could be a form of corporate welfare. How do you make sense of that?
That's a big question, but this is a new form of employment. And on the other hand, there's an advantage of this type of contracting, platform as contracting with independent workers. So there's a benefit to it. So instead of restricting their work, maybe find the positive way of helping them. So as I said, helping independent contractors to be part of social programs is one way. So the Grav and other platform companies and government has to find new ways to bring them in the social programs and providing them good working conditions, safe and decent working conditions to them. And this is not only the problem for the Philippines or issue challenges for the Philippines, but the challenges across the world.
So you did this study covering drivers from Manila, Cebu, and Davao. Are the answers similar across the board, or were there nuances, you know, unique characteristics of drivers depending on their geography?
Basically, not different across the cities, especially the reasons why they joined Grav: flexibility in employment, decent earnings, and also independent working condition. And I have to say, this finding is not unique to the Philippines. Across the world, even in a developed country like the US and Japan, workers enjoy these three flexibility, earnings, and also the independent working conditions. So across the cities, the only thing we found was that Cebu and Davao joined gig economy later. Manila expanded fast, and then Cebu and Davao. And in terms of earnings, because the low earning opportunity at Davao, so there the difference between their earning and other opportunity minimum wage rate is bigger in Davao.
All right. You know, we're talking about what, an estimated 40,000 delivery drivers for Grab here in the Philippines. And in February this year, the Grab co-founder and CEO Anthony Tan actually went to Manila, paid a courtesy call to the president, informing him of Grab's intention to generate 500,000. It's more than 10 times their current number. That's 500,000 livelihood opportunities for the Philippines. How do we even begin to imagine the exponential impact that will create in our economy?
According to the one agency in the Philippines on the creative, I forgot the name, but they estimated gig economy employment is about 1.5 million workers. The entire workforce in the Philippines is about 50 million. So already, according to the estimate, about 3% of the worker belongs to the gig economy, not only the Grab, but the other gig economies. And this number is expanding. I'm not in a position to say about a half million job or livelihood opportunity creation by the Grav. Please ask Grav representative about that. But the gig economy and employment size is expanding to a significant, you know, meaningful, detectable size. So you know, we need to keep watching, and then also we need to keep finding challenges for them and good policies to support workers in this economy.
One final question, Takashi. When you did the study about Grab delivery, of course this is not this is an independent study that ADB did.
Yes.
I wonder whether you saw some patterns of how Grab provides opportunities, for example, the senior citizens. Those who would otherwise have no longer been part of the productive segment of society in the labor force, or maybe Grab providing opportunities to solve underemployment, people with existing jobs but taking on a Grab stint as a sideline. Do you have any interesting findings on that?
Yeah, I think that was, you know, close to our interest at the beginning. we thought that the grab work may be a secondary job for the people who work on. You know, they have other job, but they take on the grab jobs as a to supplement. Especially during the pandemic, we thought that was the case, that they are not leaving their main job, but maybe taking on the grab job as a part-time job. But as it turns out, in the interview, we found that only 14% of them have having other jobs. So more than 80% of them, grab delivery is the main work. Mm. In other countries, like developed countries, elderly workers or young students take on these type of jobs as a secondary job, part-time job. However, in the Philippines, among our respondents, more than 80% of them are in the age category of 25 and 45. So in that core work force, not the elderly or students. We did not find many students, young people or elderly. The working conditions for delivery people are very tough in the Philippines. So it's hot, and then the road conditions may not be smooth, and they have to sometimes deliver at night. So we did not see many elderly or students, and I'm not sure if Grab is intentionally choosing elderly, encouraging elderly to join. One work segment that we focused on in a report is the female workers. We only found 2% of them, respondents, female workers. That's about 21 female workers. And we asked all respondents, male and female, whether they would recommend the job for the female workers. And many of them said yes. So that's a potential area maybe to expand the work opportunities to female workers.
All right, on that note, Takashi, thank you so much for the insights this morning and for the time. We look forward to more interesting reports from ADB. Have a great week.
Thank you, Michelle. Thank you very much.
All right.